students, in this video we are going to solve questions based on sum of series. Now the first question given is find the sum 3 square plus 5 square plus 7 square so on up to n terms. So you can see here that the terms are first one is 3 square, then 5 square, then 7 square, the next one will be 9 square. Because here adding 2 to this term, we are getting the next term. 5 plus 2 is 7, so next one will be 7 plus 2, 9 square. Then the next one is 11 square, like that. So first of all, let's revise what we have done in the previous video. So in the previous video, we have studied properties of sigma notation. So first property is sigma AR plus BR is sigma AR plus sigma BR. That means we have to write the sigma notation for both the terms. However, how many terms are there? We have to put sigma notation for each of the terms. In between, we have plus sign or minus sign. So this is first property. Second one is summation of k into AR. If a constant term is there, then we have to put that constant term outside the sigma notation. K summation here. This is second property. And the third one is, if it is constant only, and the term is independent of R. Here see, the term is dependent on R. As R changes, this term changes. But K is constant because it does not contain R. Similarly here it is only constant term. Then in that case, this sum is n into k, provided it is r equal to 1 to n. So k plus k plus k n times, so it is n into k. So we have these three properties of sigma notation, and we have three formula. Summation r equal to 1 to n is n plus 1 by 2. Then summation r square r equal to 1 to n is n plus 1 to n plus 1 upon 6. And the third formula is for summation r cube n square n plus 1 square upon 4. So whenever we have to solve such type of question, we have to use these properties and these formulas. Okay, now let's solve this question. First of all, we want this sum to write like this, summation sum rth term. So we want this as summation, and we want here the general term tr. But see here, each term is a square of some natural number. So this term is also square of rth term. Okay. Now rth term of which sequence? The sequence is 3, 5, 7, 9. So we have written that square here. We have to consider these numbers only now. 3, 5, 7, 7 and 9. And it is an AP. Difference is constant everywhere. First term A is 3 and difference is 2. Now let's find out rth term of this sequence so that we can substitute that term here. Now nth term for AP is A plus N minus 1 into D. This is the formula to find nth term of an AP. Now we want rth term. So first of all, we have to replace this n by r. So r minus 1 into d. Now let's substitute values of a and d. A is 3 and d is 2. So this is 3 plus 2r minus 2. That is 2r plus 1. Okay, remember every time we have to write rth term here. So rth term of this sequence is square of rth term of this AP. So now we have rth term of the AP and we have to write square of that term. So this is our required series, summation of 2r plus 1 square. Now let's check whether our this is correct or not. If r is equal to 3, we should get 7 square as it is third term in the series. So let's put r equal to 3. Substituting 3, we get 2 into 3, 6 plus 1, 7 square. See, this is correct. So substitute r equal to some value so that we can verify it. Okay. Now let's use properties of sigma notation. But the properties are only for plus minus and for constant multiplied by rth term and constant only. It is not for square. So let's square this term. So remember, it is r equal to 1 to n. So summation r equal to 1 to n. Squaring this, we get first term square, that is 4r square. 2 into first term into second term, that is 4r, and square of second term, that is 1. Now applying this property, we have to write sigma notation for each and every term. So it is summation 4r square, then summation 4r, r equal to 1 to n, and then summation 1, r equal to 1 to n. Now first two terms, here we have 4r square. So 4 is constant, so we have to write that outside the sigma notation. 4 summation r square, r equal to 1 to n. This is also 4 summation r, r equal to 1 to n. And 1 is constant, and summation of k, r equal to 1 to n, is n into k. So this is 1 into n. Value of k is 1 here. So 4 summation r square. Let's write the formula for summation r square. n plus 1, 2n plus 1 upon 6. Then 4 summation r, n plus 1 upon 2 plus n. Okay. Now we have this sum. So only thing now we have to do is we have to simplify this, and we have to write only one numerator and one denominator. So let's do this. So dividing this 4 by 2, here we have 2 and n plus 1. And here also we can divide by 2. So here it is 3. So always first take the LCM. The numbers here are 3, 1, and here it is also 1. So LCM of 3, 1 and 1 is 3. So let's write the LCM first. Now this LCM divided by this number, we have to multiply by that number to the numerator. So 3 divided by 3 is 1. So multiplying by 1, that means the term remains the same. 2n plus 1, 2n plus 1. As here it is 1, 3 divided by 1 is 3. So here multiplying by 3, we have 6, and the terms are n plus 1 as they are. Here also we have 1. So 3 by 1 is 3, multiplying this by 3, we have 3n. So now we have taken the LCM and we have written the numerator. We can take n common, as all the three terms they contain n. So taking n common, let's write the remaining term. Taking n common, the remaining terms are 2n plus 1, then 2n plus 1. Taking n common, the remaining terms are 6 and n plus 1. Taking n common from this term, it is 3 only, divided by 3. So n, then we have to write the product of these two brackets. So it is 2n square plus n plus 2n plus 1. 6, let's write this n plus 1 as it is. In the next one, multiply the bracket by 6. So let's now multiply this bracket by 2, as it is 2 into bracket. So 2 into 2n square, that is 4n square, then 2n, then 4n. Either you can add these two terms and then multiply by 2, or you can write like this also. 2 into 1 is 2, then 6n plus 6 plus 3, divided by 3. Now this is n, and adding these terms, 4n square, then let's collect term in n. It is 2n, 4n and 6n. 6 plus 4 is 10 plus 2 is 12n, and the constant term is here, it is 2, 6, 8 plus 3 is 11, divided by 3. So this is the required sum. So let's revise the steps. First step is find rth term, that is first step. Second step is use properties of sigma notation here. Write the formulas, take LCM and add those terms. Okay. Now consider this next question. 1 into 3 plus 5 into 7 plus 9 into 11, so on up to n terms. It is not 1.3. It is 1 multiplied by 3. Then 5 multiplied by 7 and so on. Now the first step is we have to write this as summation of rth term of this series. Now each term contains product of two numbers. So whenever we write summation, we have to write two brackets, as it is product of two numbers. Let's find out relation between these two numbers. If we add 2 to this term, we get the next one. See, 5 plus 2 is 7, 9 plus 2 is 11. So it is enough to find the first bracket. Adding 2 to this, we will get the next bracket. So let's find out this bracket first. Let's consider first numbers. The first numbers are 1, 5, 9, so on. So we are considering only the first numbers from each product of this series. So 1, 5, 9. So those are the first numbers. Now the difference here is constant. 5 minus 1 is 4, 9 minus 5 is also 4. That means it is an AP and first term is 1 and common difference is 4. So let's find out rth term, because here we have to write rth term. So nth term is a plus n minus 1 into d. So replacing n by r, we get rth term. A plus, instead of n, now write r. Let's put value of a and d. A is 1 and d is 4. So this is 1 plus, multiplying these two terms by 4, we have 4r minus 4. That is 4r minus 3. So now our first bracket is 4r minus 3. And for the next one, we have to add 2 to the first bracket. So let's add that 2. So that will be 4r minus 3 plus 2. So this sum becomes now summation r equal to 1 to n 4r minus 3 multiplied by 4r minus 1. Okay. Now let's check whether this is correct or not. Let's put r equal to 2. Whenever we put r equal to 2, we should get second term. Second term is 5 into 7. Let's check. If we put r equal to 2, we get 4 into 2, 8 minus 3, 5, correct? Then 4 into 2, 8 minus 1, 7. So our answer is correct. So first find the rth term and verify it also. So next one is sigma notation properties for summation or plus sign or minus sign. It is not for product. So we have to complete this product first. So let's multiply these two brackets. 4r multiplied by 4r is 16r square. Then 4r multiplied by minus 1 is minus 4r. Minus 3 into 4r is minus 12r. Minus minus plus 3. See, we have written rth term. Then we multiply those two brackets. Now the simplification. That 16r square, and we can add these two terms in the middle one. So adding these two terms, we have 16r plus 3. So in between we should have only plus or minus sign, so that we can use properties of sigma notation. Now the properties say that we have to write sigma notation for each term. So it is sigma 16r square from r equal to 1 to n. The next one is minus sign, add as it is. Sigma 16r, r equal to 1 to n, and writing sigma notation for this also, we have summation 3 from r equal to 1 to n. Now write the constant term outside the sigma notation. So 16 summation r square, r equal to 1 to n, minus 16 summation r equal to 1 to n, and as it is only constant, if it is constant, multiply by n. So the sum is 3n. Okay. Now let's substitute this value of summation r square. It is n plus 1, 2n plus 1 upon 6. 16 summation r is n plus 1 upon 2. Plus 3n, that means it is divided by 1. So let's simplify. Dividing by 2, here we get 8. Here dividing by 2, we have 3, and here 8. Now take LCM of the denominator. 3, 1, 1. LCM is 3. Now 3 divided by 3 is 1. So this numerator is multiplied by 1. So So multiply by 1, we get 8, n plus 1, 2n plus 1. Now 3 divided by 1 is 3. So multiplying this by 3, we have 8 into 3. That is 24, n plus 1. And 3 divided by 1 is 3. So again we have to multiply this term by 3. So it becomes 9n. Okay, first take the LCM. Now we can take n common as every term contains n. So taking n common and writing the remaining terms. We have 8n plus 1, 2n plus 1. Taking n common, here we have 24n plus 1. Take n common from this term too. So it is 9 divided by 3. So n, 8, let's write the product. 2n square plus n plus 2n plus 1 minus 24n plus 1 plus 9 upon 3. So n, now let's multiply all these 4 terms by 8. So it is 16n square, then 8n, 16n plus 8. Multiplying these two terms by minus 24, we have minus 24n minus 24 plus 9 divided by 3. So that is n, 16n square. Now let's add term in n. So here we have 8n and 16n. That is 24n minus 24n. So it get cancelled. Okay. And constant term, 8 plus 9 is 17. So we are adding the term having plus sign. 17 minus 24 is minus 7 divided by 3. So this is our answer. Now in this question, it is not sum up to n terms. So here we have finite terms. Let's find out how many terms are there. So we have brackets here. 40 square minus 39 square, it should be 39 square, plus 38 square minus 37 square, plus 36 square minus 35 square, so on up to the last one is 2 square minus 1 square. You can see here we have 20 brackets. Why 20 brackets? Because we have the numbers from 1 to 40. 1 to 40 numbers, that means we have written in all 40 numbers, but pairwise. So this we have put bracket for two terms or two numbers. So 40 divided by 2 is 20. So in all we have 20 brackets. If you are not comfortable with this sequence, because backward counting is a little bit difficult, so let's write like this. 2 square plus 1 square. The next one will be 4 square minus 3 square. You can see here that the first number is always even number. And the second one is odd number, like that. 40 square minus 39 square, like this. Okay. Now you can see here that the first numbers, 2, 4, 6, in the next one, we will be having 8, like that. So these are even numbers. So, or using the formula for nth term of an AP also, you can find it. Okay, let's use both the methods. It is even number. You can see here that it is 2 into 1. This is 2 into 2. This is 2 into 3. 2 into 4. First term, 2 into 1. Second term, 2 into 2. Third term, 2 into 3. Fourth term, 2 into 4. So, nth term, 2 into n. Rth term, 2 into r. So, we want rth term. So, it is 2r. Okay. As it is 2r, the next one is 2r minus 1. We are subtracting 1 from this number. See, 4. Then here we have 3. 40. Here we have 39. So it is 2r minus 1. Or using formula for nth term of an AP also you can find it. See, tr is a plus r minus 1 into d. As nth term is a plus n minus 1 into d. For r, we have to replace n by r. So now here, a is 2, first term is 2, and difference is also 2. So A is 2 and difference means D is also 2. So it is 2 plus 2R minus 2. So it is 2R. See, we have written 2R. Even number terms, they are 2 into R. So we have to find out summation R equal to 1 to, now it is not N, it is 20, because we have 20 brackets. So R equal to 1 to 20. And in the bracket, the first number is even number. So it is 2R bracket square, as it is square of each term. So 2R bracket square minus, the next one is we have to subtract 1 from this number and again square of that number. Okay. Now let's simplify this. So this is summation R equal to 1 to 20. Let's square this. So 2R bracket square, squaring both the terms, we have 4R square. Squaring this bracket, it is 4R square minus 4R plus 1. So summation R equal to 1 to 20. Now let's remove this round bracket. So we have to change the sign of each term in this round bracket. Plus 4R minus 1. So 4R square minus 4R square get cancelled. So let's write the remaining term. R equal to 1 to 20. 4R minus 1. Okay. Now, by property of sigma notation, we have to write sigma notation for both the terms. So summation R equal to 1 to 20 4R minus summation R equal to 1 to 20 1. So this is 4 summation R equal to 1 to 20 minus, see, whenever we have summation K, it is N into K. But what is N? R equal to 1 to N. N is this number and we have to write that number here multiplied by this number. Now compare these two. N is 20 now. So this is 20 into compare K. So value of k is 1 here, so 20 into 1. See the meaning, it is 1 plus 1 plus 1 20 times. That means it is 1 into 20, so that's why it is minus 20 here. 4, now formula for summation r. Summation r, let's write here. Summation r equal to 1 to n is n plus 1 upon 2. Comparing these two, we have n equal to 20. So we have to put n equal to 20 in the right hand side. So the value is 20. Then 20 plus 1 divided by 2. Minus 20. We are not taking the LCM or anything here, because we are substituting a number here. And substituting the number, we can simplify easily. So this is 4 into 10. That is 40 multiplied by 21. Minus 20. So that is 840 minus 20. And that is 820. Okay. So this is your today's assignment. These three questions. And referring the video or the questions given in this video, you can easily solve these questions. Okay. Thank you. See you in the next video.